the applause is for the magnificent performance by Bernie Perron, the premier goaltender of the NHL.
Montreal native Bernie Perron grew up watching the Canadians and idolizing their goaltender.
My idol was Pierre Blanc. I loved him. His sister lived next door to us, so he used to come in once a year during the summer. I forget this. He would get out of his big car. He had a hat on, big cigar. He'd walk around. I watched him. I was too scared to shake hands with him.
Perron eventually got the chance to meet and learn from his childhood hero when they became teammates in 1971.
He was a goalie in Toronto. He was 43 years old at the time. It was incredible. I would watch him during the games. And finally, I asked him, I said, can you teach me? Bingo, he said, sure. So that changed my whole career.
Jock was a very good angle goaltender. So he used to bring these strings and ropes out in the ice, and he had proved to Bernie, if you play in this position, you'll blip this shot. Or play that position, you'll be in control of the shots when they come to you.
A year later, Perron moved on from the Leafs, taking with him the lessons learned from Plante.
What I learned from him was the understanding of the game.
Perron is a landmark figure for the Philadelphia Flyers. They had selected him from Boston in the 1967 expansion draft, and he was their top goaltender for 3.5 years before being traded to Toronto. But in 1973, he returned to Philadelphia, continuing his success in the net while beginning to forge his place in hockey history.
He's a stand-up goaltender, never went down. He always steered the pucks to the corners. You know, if there was a shot in net, you know where it had to go to retrieve it to get control of the puck again.
Some great goaltending by Bernie Perron.
Classic skate save.
Played his angle extremely well. Very, very seldom you cut Bernie down, and that's why he was tough to score on.
In 73-74, Perron began one of the most historic goaltending runs in hockey history, winning a record 47 games, a mark that would stand for 33 years.
Well, I think like every player, when you get to the playoffs, your game rises, and his did.
Perron led the Flyers to the franchise's first Stanley Cup final, and they faced off against the Boston Bruins.
I think Boston took us a little bit lightly, because we were an expansion team, only 7 years in existence.
We would never have won the first cup wasn't for Bernie, because 3 minutes to go in the game and Ken Hodge comes down, lets the shot go, and I'm on the bench, sitting on the bench, I could see the shot angling, it's going for the wide, far post, and Bernie just happened to stick his toe out there just as it was going in the net, and I think we all knew that we're going to win the cup there.
Perron capped off his historic season by bringing home the Vezina trophy. All of this success was only fuel for him to burn the following season as the Flyers played their way right back to the Stanley Cup final.
It's all over! The Flyers have won the second in a row! The Flyers have won their second consecutive Stanley Cup!
Well, I think he actually played better in the second series against Buffalo in the finals. We had taken a lot of penalties, and Buffalo had some players that could really shoot the puck. They had the great Gilbert Perreault. They had the French connection there. Bernie was on his game then, and that he was really instrumental in that second cup.
The most valuable player in the playoffs, Bernie Perron, wins it the second year in a row.
Now, the second year we won in Buffalo, we got on the plane, a charter back to Philly. We put the Stanley Cup in the middle of the aisle. The whole plane got quiet. All we did for a half hour, look at this beautiful trophy. It was so beautiful.
Perron once again won the Vezina, completing one of the most commanding stretches ever for a goaltender. In 1979, Perron suffered an eye injury that cut his career short. But his historic era for the Broad Street Bullies will live long in memory.
For 5 or 6 years there, he was the best in the game. That's pretty good.
You have a goal, you have a vision, so whatever you want to do in life, don't quit. You know, there'll be times where it's going to be dark, where you keep pushing, and eventually you get the rewards. Beautiful thing.